So in the previous video, we made this game where we had a background image and then we added the two sprites. So if you haven't already watched that video, make sure that you go and watch that one first. And then we're going to start with this one and do a tile background scene, which gives you a little bit better control over things and allows you to put in some walls and things like that. So we're going to go to scene. And then instead of set background image, we're going to go down here to tile map and grab this set tile map to, and it's going to be blank initially. So I'm going to dock that into our start. Let's just move this around. So let me move this down a little bit. And then I'm going to get rid of the background image. So notice I can pull everything out and this stuff still stays stuck to the bottom. Then I can just grab the one where I want it to separate and then pull it back over. To get rid of this one, I can grab it and then just slide it over and this becomes a trash can and then let go and then it's gone. Or you can just grab it and hit delete. So I want to set a tile map. So this is blank right now. So I'm going to click on this. This brings me up to my tile map. And I'm going to do just a really simple path. And let me go back and kind of dice it up and put some borders. And fix that little problem there. And fix this little problem here. And let me fix this side. Okay, so I've got my path mapped out. Now I'm just going to do a real simple fill for the rest of it. So you've got the pencil, you've got the eraser, and then you also have the fill tool. So we'll click on the fill tool, just grab some of this generic background. And then you can go back and add, you know, fancier stuff if you want to. You've got several different tile galleries here. So there's forest, aquatic, dungeon, miscellaneous, and then you can also go back and create your own tiles if you want to. And within forest, you can see it has several, within each of these, it has several different options. You can also change the size of the tile map down here. This is a 16 by 16. So I'm going to click done just to see what it looks like. There we go. And then we restarted. Okay, so I really want the sprite player to show up on the path instead of being in this grassy area. So under scene, it has this place my sprite on top of random. So instead of this set player sprite to position, I'm going to take this off now. And now, oops, and then now ditch this one. And then again, since I renamed it, I have to make sure that this is my player sprite. And then I can just select what I want the player sprite to appear on. So I want the player sprite to appear on the path. So it's going to now place the player on the path. And I'm going to duplicate this block and put it down here. And I'm going to change this so that my food also appears on the path. Now you'll notice that you're only seeing just a very small portion of the window here. So we need the camera to update and show us the actual player location. Oops. And so we can do that by going into scene and then just scroll on down. And then you've got this camera follow sprite. That's kind of the most basic mode. So let's do that. And then we'll change this to be my player sprite. So let's take a look and see how our game is going now. So now our camera is centered on our sprite, and as we move our sprite, our camera moves along with it. We still should have the same functionality that when we overlap with the food disappears. So that looks good.